The months-long settled blockade against the tiny Gulf emirate of Qatar has not impacted the American forces stationed there, a top U.S. Air Force general told Al Monitor today. Located just south of the capital Doha, Al Udeid Air Base hosts more than 10,000 U.S. troops. It's been a major hub for the U.S. Air Force in the Gulf for 15 years and is the only American runway in the Gulf long enough to allow U.S. B-52 bombers to target Islamic State as militants in Iraq and Syria. No impact, Gen. Robin Rand, commander of Air Force Global Strike Command, told Al Monitor when asked about the blockade's effect of the blockade on U.S. operations. In fact, we're flying more sorties per week now than we were before the embargo. The Air Force first deployed B-52 bombers to Al Udeid in April 2016 in support of Operation Inherent Resolve, a Mas-backed effort to eliminate its safe havens. First introduced in the 1950s, the Boeing-made strategic bomber gives U.S. forces the ability to attack targets deep inside Iraq and Syria. Before the United States started using Al Udeid in 2001, the military stationed B-52s in Saudi Arabia during Operation Desert Storm in 1991 and flew occasional missions from a Navy facility at Diego Garcia, an island in the middle of the Indian Ocean. Rand declined to provide Al Monitor with specific figures on anti-ice bombing missions from the base but said three B-52 squadrons operating on six-month rotations since 2016 have flown an increasing number of bombing missions against the militant group. The USALT coalition in Iraq and Syria conducted more than 5,000 strikes on its targets in August, a record for the three-year mission. Typically, the Air Force stations one bomber squadron at Al Udeid, that includes six B-52 aircraft. The 185,000-pound plane can hold around 70,000 pounds of weapons, such as mines, missiles and the U.S. military's strongest bunker-busting bombs. Rand's comments at the Air Force Association's annual conference come as the Pentagon has pushed to maintain US-Qatar military relations throughout the embargo. In June, U.S. Defense Secretary Jim Mattis said Qatar had a strategic role to play against IS, despite persistent criticism from Gulf countries that Doha supports Islamist groups and is too cozy with Iran. Qatar recently put more than $5 billion into upgrading facilities at Al Udeid. When asked how a continued embargo could impact U.S. bombing missions in the long term, Rand played down any immediate concerns. Obviously, if we weren't working out of Al Udeid, there would be a little bit of a transition, he said. But we're not being told to prepare for that. Jack Detch is Al Monitor's Pentagon correspondent. Based in Washington, Detch examines US Middle East relations through the lens of the Defense Department. Detch previously covered cybersecurity for Passcode, the Christian Science Monitor's project on security and privacy in the digital age. Detch also served as editorial assistant at The Diplomat magazine and worked for unaffiliated stations in San Francisco. On Twitter @JackDetch. Email jdetch@almonitor.com.